Okay, so like I was saying. Okay, cleanse the people, Moses, because, you know, 3 days from now, Jah's going to show up. The lamb's been sacrificed. That's Jesus Christos taking the form of the lamb, representing the lamb. So this is talking about right now. The third day. Now, if the days begin in the evening, then the third day doesn't necessarily start when the third day finishes. When it begins. So 2,000 years. Peter says, I would not that you be ignorant of this, that a day with the Lord is as 1,000 years. So okay, Jesus Christos, 2,000 years ago, he was that lamb. And so the whole doorpost, the blood on the
dedication of life.
Yeah. So now he's been sacrificed, right? On the third day, the reason why resurrected. See, the second coming is 3 days after the sacrifice on the cross. Nobody ever counts that one. Everybody's talking about second coming. He came the second time. He was born from the Virgin Mary, and then he was crucified, and 3 days later he rose from the dead. This is the third. This is the power of the Trinity. So 2,000 years later, hold on, 2,000 years later, beginning the third day, he's going to appear.
Because it's like a dress rehearsal.
It was a look into the future. See, Jesus Christus is the spirit of prophecy, so he showed even what was going to happen in the future. He showed it then to give us a glimpse, to be able to be like, to compare and to see, to give us a chance. So what he did was representing what was in, he did in spirit, even though he was in the flesh, it was literally in the authority of the kingdom for the Father, Haile Selassie first. Mm-hmm. It was actually representing what was going to happen now.
On the
20th century.
When the master comes to the property and say, what did you do to my son?
Well, he judges him. He takes away the sin from him. He drops the charges because they're false accusations.
Exactly.
So he raises him from the dead, from this whitewashed, corrupted, false, no good for nothing, like just mm-hmm. terrorist Christ, mm-hmm. to the real, true, and living God. The Son of the living God.
Those ones in that parable that Christ talks about, that a man with a vineyard sent his workers.
Yeah, and he took off
for
a while.
They beat him up. They beat up the servants. Then he sent his son, and they killed him.
Which of the prophets have you not murdered? And then they killed Stephen too because he went too far, according to the Pharisees. But now let's go forward. Okay, so knowing that chapter 20 would, before they receive, and chapter 19 in Exodus, and chapter 20 that's talking about now in spirit and truth. So set up borders, right? Now we never follow instruction, but when it's time to see God, all of a sudden everybody's all mm-hmm. listening, and oh, we can't pass that border. Mm-hmm. When they should be interested, hey, heck it, I'm going to take a chance. I'm going to see. This is God, right? Exactly. God's a man. He does have feelings. And no one is willing to die to see me?
Exactly.
Yeah. No one's willing to take the chance?
To see me?
Like, you took a chance
to cross
a lot of different things, but not to see me? You know, when it comes to like a girlfriend or something like that, you take many chances. But just because
her daddy and the shotgun,
whatever. But when it comes to like to get a glimpse of me, nobody dared like break the rules a little.
Hmm. Is that pre-Shekinah glory that followed them, or the cloud, or is that they followed because they wanted to be that far off and just kind of follow the glory?
I'm specifically talking about like chapter 19 and mm-hmm. 20 mm-hmm. of the book of Exodus.
Thank you.
Now, that's a way for me to derive that question that I don't have the answer right now because I'm not thinking about that.
Okay, cool. But, I actually got too far ahead.
But what's it called? So now, he's going to appear. And when Jah says, oh, Moses, tell the people not to come up, you know? And he's all like, oh, no, the people can't come up because you set bounds. He said, get away. Like if he was hurt in his feelings. Now people say, oh, but he's got, yeah, and he.
If you love Jah, I don't care, Father, I'm coming to see you. I see what you're saying.
Yeah, nobody dared. Okay. So you break the law for some dumb stuff, but when it comes to, like, you don't bend the rules to kind of like get a glimpse of God. You know, you bend the rules for anything else but God, you know?
Exactly.
You would assume that you'd be like, hey, F it. I'll do anything to if I'm really into him. Since, you know, I guess we'll kick back right here. We'll stay, you know. I mean, they did send, they did put borders, you know. Like, anyways, now, what am I trying to get to? That they turned back. They turned back. And you don't turn back from Jah, because then he can't reach you. They turned back, and there's nothing that he can do because you yourself rejected him. Now, okay, that's... You have the right to judge for yourself what you're going to do. You know, Jesus Christ said, if you lose your life for my sake, trying to get close to me, you'll save it. But if you save your life, you'll lose it.
Exactly.
You know, exactly. Rather strive for those things that are eternal than those things that are that please the flesh for just a second. But skipping all that, like, okay, because they went back, now Jah, you're not with Jah. See, Jah is willing to put up with all our BS as long as we're with him.
Exactly.
As soon as we're gone, there's nothing he could do. It's like a mother. Like, no matter, you'll get punishments.
Yeah,
but as long as you're there and she can, she has authority over you. She could be like, as long as you're in my house,
exactly.
I don't care what how mad you get. You're gonna do as I tell you, and you're gonna pay the consequences for your. But she always has a sense of she never really like abandons you. But the minute you walk out, the minute you walk out and leave her life and you far away, you're on your own. There's really nothing she can do.
She don't know.
It's the same thing with Jah. The minute you turn some other direction.
To walk out the gate.
You on your own. You on your own.
Like, you know, like he can encampus. His angels, what is that? The campus around you, right? His angels encampus, right? That's scripture. I could be a little wrong. But when you break that security wall, you climb it or cut a hole through it and sneak out. Dude, you open up. You know what I'm saying? The angels do not encamp around you, honey. You just broke open the. You left. It's one thing to walk out and say, I'm out. But it's another thing when you sneak out the door. You know, you ever got busted? I used to do this when I was little. Not little, but I was in high school. My mom used to let me go out to clubs with my fake ID. She encouraged it. Oh, no. You want an inch? You're going to take a mile, right? Somebody give you an inch, you're going to take a mile. No. After I was done with the clubs, right, I come home at, mom said, come home at 2 o'clock. Okay, I still stumble at 3 o'clock in the morning. Now, there's some after parties that's going on, too. Well up in the clock in the morning, you know what I'm saying? When the sun starts coming in, mom sleeps late, you know what I'm saying?
What?
Okay, you know how many months I did? I came home, I'm back from the party, mom, a little early. She go to sleep, sneak out the window, go to the after party, get home just before the sun come up, you know what I'm saying? Like, dude, Southern California, until the day I got busted.
Well, okay, check it. It's in Exodus 19, and it says, and Mount Sinai, verse 18, Mount Sinai was altogether up in a smoke, because the Lord descended upon it in fire. So we have smoke and fire. And the smoke thereof ascended as the smoke of a furnace. So the smoke wasn't coming from the fire. The fire wasn't fire. But if you got a guilty conscience and you turn back, and you're Israel, so-called, but you didn't go all the way. You were scared because you ain't gotta be scared to get close to Jah. And if you die, so be it.
Yes.
It says that don't let any animal or any person cross the borders, because then you'll get shot or stoned or pierced. Well, what if you get pierced by the Holy Spirit? But no one ever really considered that. It's not to blame him because the Holy Spirit wasn't. Jesus Christus had not given himself up, right? But still, the example for us. No one was willing to take a shot. You know, a lot of people have touched Jesus Christus, but it was the ones that touched them with faith, with an attention. Who touched me? Come on, Jesus. I mean, there's like a big-ass crowd. What do you mean? No, but someone touched me desiring to be healed. Someone, I sensed with virtue, intent, power coming
she
from
had
me.
The eye and eye
and she was like, it was me.
Exactly.
Okay, go. Your faith has cleared you. She didn't get shot. Exactly. She didn't get pierced.
She got pierced by the love.
Yeah.
She got shot.
That's the thing that Israel rejected.
She acted. You know what? They fell on the stone. They could have fell on the stone and then broken, but they were thinking stone.
So now, the smoke is actually the prayers of the saints. It's us ascending as a cloud. He was taken up. He was taken up by a cloud of people. He was taken up by a cloud of people, and he's the illumination. His glory is so bright. So people are misinterpreting it, are giving a wrong judgment and thinking it's fire and thinking it's smoke. But here's why I can prove that the smoke is representative not only of the prayers but of the faithful, mm-hmm. called and chosen, because it says that the Lord descended upon it in fire, and the smoke thereof ascended as the smoke of a furnace. The ones being called out from Sheol, from the burning, from the testing, from the proving with fire. Bring to me gold tried by fire, Jesus Christus says in Revelation 3:14. Mm-hmm. He says, bring to me gold that's tested or proved by fire. Mm-hmm. So from the furnace, from the hell, those that cried out to him. You know, those that, so he, this smoke that's arising, it's the prayers of the saints, and our prayers are our desire. So free us from this bondage, O Almighty God. So the soul is lifting up and it's rising, not to Mount Sinai, that Mount Sinai to them, Mount Zion to us. Amen. And now, you know, the
on
Lord,
the other side of that, on the other side,
because they didn't get close enough. They went, they were on the other side of the mountain.
Exactly.
They were seeing the backside. They were probably seeing the rough and the rugged
The death side.
They were getting what did you see? What did you hear? They didn't.
The hearsay.
Oh, I heard that they said that that the Lord said. Oh, now you're getting cut off. You know?
You didn't see it yourself.
You didn't see it yourself. So it says that. And when the voice of the trumpet sounded longer, it could be the first trumpet, might as well be the last. Who cares about the second, third, fourth, fifth, if you didn't hear the first one?
Exactly.
You ain't going to get it. You didn't come up to the first one. So it got louder and louder. So it's like when Ananias is talking to people, and His Imperial Majesty, blah, 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 1963, blah, blah, blah. Ah, shut up. Exactly. You know, because the trumpet is getting too clear. This shit's getting too clear. No, I don't want to hear it. You know,
I got to go.
I don't want to talk to you anymore. So, and so the foundation gets shaken, because then it goes on to say that
and even the foundation of their minds.
Well, the earth. You are the earth. So everything quakes. Everything's shaken.
Daniel's prophecy.
Everything you think is not. So everything
stone.
You stand on is like, oh my God, what do you do? Everything
stone
I thought.
Stone cut without man hands.
Yeah, that's him
hit
too.
The feet. But anyway.
But you're standing on ground. So when everything is being shaken and like, for instance, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you can move mountains. Well, what if I told you, like I told Curtis, well, guess what? Jerusalem, voila, I just moved it to Ethiopia, mm-hmm. and I didn't even have to do anything. And he looked at me like, oh my God, like, I know what you're saying, you're right. So I just moved the mountain. So your whole earth, your whole foundation got shooken. You were thinking of some fantasy Mickey Mouse, like Disney Channel, Hocus Pocus. No, my faith is strong because he is real just now as he is then, as he will ever be. So guess what? Jerusalem, I just moved it to Ethiopia. I did that. You're looking, you're praying to a wall, you're worshiping a wall.
Yeah, something like
that. And I'm telling you that, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David hath prevailed to open the book and loosen the seven seals. So then it goes on.
Get your passport.
So it got louder and louder. Moses spake, and God answered him by a voice, and the Lord came down upon Mount Sinai on the top of the mount, and the Lord called Moses up to the top of the mount. Who's willing to go like Moses up to the top? See, they're already away from Egypt. They're across the river. So they're far from the church system. They're far from the civilization. They're in the desert. But now you got to ascend to the high mountain. So it's not only about getting away, but it's ascending. And
you're climbing. You got to come up. You got to get hard. You take breaks when you got to do them climbing.
Said, and
you breathe in.
And the Lord
the air
said,
is getting thinner.
The Lord said to Moses,
colder.
Go down, charge the people, lest they break through to the Lord to gaze. And guess what? How sad it was when all of his chosen people didn't dare take a look.
Oh, dude.
Imagine how you would have felt.
Oh, my God.
Imagine how you would have felt. Like, if you expecting your people to greet you with, oh, Jai, you just saved us and stuff. And they're all like, no, we can't go because Moses set bounds. Oh, that's how much. Oh, now you acting holy?
Like, oh, dude. It's like, okay, you have an artist coming. It's more than that. It's like, oh, okay, well, here we're going to have balance with the press and this.
Oh, okay. Well, we ain't coming because, you know, you said there's bounds and, you know, that's okay. It's weird. You know, it's like so effed up, dude.
Yeah, and no one showed up to the party.
They weren't planning anyway.
So, now...
Now they made an excuse. They weren't... Well, no. But you know what? No, you know what, Moses? No, that's cool because you set bounds and... you know what? You tell us what happened over there. You know,
Well, it all comes down to a guilty conscience.
Yeah.
Because if you're okay with the fact that, you know what, I've done a lot of wrong, but I don't care. So what? What am I gonna lose? Think about it. If you already like done so many sins and stuff like that, what is it there to lose? Hey, that's God. Go check it out. You know, like be interested at least in the right thing. Now, this is what they missed out. They saw thunder and fire and smoke and the earthquake and the trumpet was louder and the voice, you know, they were scared. But this is what, if they would have gone up with Moses, this is what they would have heard.
Like,
This is what they missed out. This is what they would have heard. And he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger." See, he's saying, like, blessed are those that were willing to die in order to come close to God. Because the arm of God is extended and we were eating from a tree of knowledge and good and evil, thinking God is good. Why would he take us out of Egypt and do us wrong?
Exactly.
That just don't even make sense.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe he just wants us, try us a little bit, see if we really down. But we obviously not. So they saw a reflection of their evil self in thunder, lightning, when in reality, it was the most beautiful thing. Because it was Jesus Christus up on the mount giving the sermon of not judgment. They got judgment. Mm. They got judgment because they didn't come up. So Moses had to be there. This is what went on. And because you can't express the truth in words,
wow,
a truth so big. Here's 10 tablets that pretty much sum it up.
Mm-hmm.
But you got judgment instead of God in grace and mercy.
Mm.
But I'll explain the tablets. But it goes on. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger for manna, for the face, to see the face of this man that has saved them. So when I start saying Haile Selassie is God, that's too much. That's too much. I don't want to see his face. I just want him to get me out of Egypt, get me some cars, you know. But I don't need to see his face,
exactly.
Really. So
can I wear it as a T-shirt?
Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
Mm-hmm.
The ones that don't care, I am what I am. I messed up. I don't know, but I'm gonna see.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, the ones that are okay with, that just accept themselves. And don't pass judgment on this. Like, just let it be. Whatever.
Well, and also in the book of Zadra, somewhere it talks about those who are able to separate the soul self from this artificial, basically, the fake mind, the fake art. You know what I'm saying? The illusion.
Well, yeah, they caught up in judgment.
Mm-hmm.
You know, God. They say God is good. God is, then how come you're not willing to see him? Because whenever truth begins to speak,
you don't
want to receive it. So now let me tell you what the tablets mean.
Mm-hmm.
The tablets represent us.
Mm.
Because he's so merciful. Really what was going on is that the saints were being called up in spirit and in truth, like the prayers ascending your innermost desires, like save me from this, and so be it, because he's so compassionate towards his people that he would not,
mm-hmm,
that you perish. So here we go up, ascending up as a cloud and as a prayer, which is the substance, which we
and
are
that's
the
sacrifice.
We're the faith.
That's what Christ asked for now. The sacrifice is in the praise and worship.
And here we go up, ascending, and we see him on the mount.
David.
We see him on the mount preaching the blessings. the other people get the curse.
Wow.
Remember, one mountain, one side gets the blessing and the other mountain gets the curse?
Kind of like what they do now in, like, segregation and, like, the rich people get the good area and the poor people. In America, you have, like, the southeast area.
Or actually, I think in the center it was, I may have been wrong on that.
Yeah, but in areas like this, like, America's southeast is usually Hispanic and blacks. You notice that. And then, like, north and the northeast, northwest. But another, it all depends on which is the most geographic better location. But, yes.
And as this is going on, we're seeing His Majesty sitting upon the throne that says, "Behold, my Son, in whom I am well pleased." Exactly. But because God is so merciful, He said, "Rastafari, true and not just any Rasta, but the true and faithful that remain in the Mashiach, come down and save your brothers and sisters that didn't come up." Mm-hmm. So we get sent as tablets, but really as the book living, that the tablets are in the heart. And we get sent down to earth as angels, messengers. It doesn't have to be like this hocus pocus, magic, whatever, false imagination. So we, in our hearts, have the command. Not the commands that you get when you're in the outside, but the ones that you get when you're up there, the mercy and the grace. Because we didn't hear the same thing, obviously. Because you ran. And far away, I ran towards. I heard grace and mercy because that's what I desired. You desired judgment, and so you ran from yourself. You just an expression. You just a reflection. See, we see Him, the mirror image of ourselves. So we see the glory from generation to generation where He be, we be, because the Son said, "I go to the Father and I make a space for you, and so that you may dwell in me, through me, in Him." So, because I'm in Him and you with me, then we won. Mm-hmm. We tewahido. Because Jesus Christus, that's why He made that sacrifice, so that we can... He goes to the Father and we being in Him, you know?
Pull up from it.
Yeah.
No, I'm listening.
Yeah, I kind of want... Yeah. Hold up. I'm looking for...
But no, it's not.
I'm actually... looking for 2 Corinthians, which is a inner joke because of the whole inside joke because of the whole the Trump. I'm looking for 2 Corinthians. And 2 Corinthians. Nah, I'm looking for the second
Cruz,
epistle.
Because Cruz right in.
Then it's
the Trump. The 2 Corinthians who are gonna be the voting twist. Maybe the 2 Corinthians is Bernie and Hillary.
Watch, it said, no thanks, now thanks be the ministry of triumph. It says 2 Corinthians, or 2 Corinthians, second epistle. Now thanks be to God, which always causes us to triumph in Christ and make it manifest the savor of his knowledge by us in every place. Also the sacrifices of the savor, the smell. Press that button.
Oh, there you go. Okay, got it. Lion's den.
And then it says, for we are to God a sweet savor of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
A burnt, the furnace, the you know, burning the flesh, and ascending
I smell
in spirit.
Burning. I didn't even know that. Wow, crazy. Ascending in spirit.
So now it says, the savor of, for we are to God a sweet savor of Christ in them that are saved and in them that perish. In them that perish, to the one we are the savor of death to death, and to the other the savor of life to life. So if you got life in your mind, and you desire life, and you're okay with
you
life being what it is, and
you
ain't judgmental, just accept His revelation to be, and you don't make up your own imagination and pretend God to be to your image and likeness, and you just accept what. So what? He manifested like the King of Kings of Ethiopia, Haile Selassie first. So what? That is what it is. So then
beautiful
you
power.
Seek your life, and so like attracts like, then you're going to attract life.
Exactly.
If you got death in your... Well, going forward, he said, for we are not as many which corrupt the word of God, but as of sincerity, but as of God, in the sight of God, speak we in Christ. The ministry accredited, do we begin again to commend ourselves, or need we, as some others, epistles of of commendation to you, or letters of commendation from you. Ye are our epistle, written in our hearts, known and read of all men. For as much as ye are manifestly declared to be the epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God. Not in tables of stone, but in fleshy tables of the heart. And such trust have we through Christ to Godward. Moses was to be the one that inquired to Godward, but God didn't want this to be a Moses teacher. He wanted every one of us to be to him Godward. Mm-hmm. So we don't need no middleman. He got enough love for all of us. Mm-hmm. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, but our sufficiency is of God. Now the ministry spiritual and glorious, not legal, who also hath made us able ministers of the New Testament, not of the letter, but of the Spirit. For the letter killeth, but the Spirit giveth life. But if the administration of death, written and engraven in stones, was glorious, so that the children of Israel could not steadfastly behold the face of Moses for the glory of his countenance, which glory was to be done away. So he comes down, and because Moses was up there, he was illuminated, but people don't wanna partake in the glory. It's like, nah, Rastaman, I'm not that kind of Rastaman. I want to do my own thing. Exactly. I don't want to glory in the Bible.
You know what? I believe it. Yeah, he's like, I believe in myself.
Yeah, I don't want to glory in the Bible because the Bible.
Yeah, yes, he was a good guy. And, blah, blah, blah. And with some other bullshit that they'll
So it says, how shall not the ministration of the Spirit be rather glorious? For if the ministration of condemnation be glory, much more doth the ministration of righteousness exceed in glory. Right. For even that which was made glorious had no glory in this respect, by reason of glory that excelleth. For if that which is done away, let me just it's not fair to do that, but what I want to get to is that these ones were blinded, but now the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty to think for yourselves the way to serve God, and not through a law.
To do the right thing.
To the consciousness, to yourself, you have the freedom to be like
Christ.
I'm going to think for myself the way I'm going to serve the Almighty. Yeah. And by doing so, inevitably, as a result, you will learn the way to serve your fellow brothers and sisters within the human community. Because once they heard Christ, Christ said, here's what I want you to do. First love God more than anyone, and then love your neighbor as thyself. Yeah. He didn't speak to this is my commandment. But since you got the short end of the stick.
Yeah, you heard it said.
You didn't get the staff, what I'm saying?
Oh, dude, you've heard it said.
But you didn't hear what I said for real, because you weren't paying attention.
Yes.
Now, it's because you were reading the book.
You heard it said, eye for an eye.
You were looking in the Bible trying to correct my angel that I sent in form of man, and I declare that I am Wendell Alonso Tafara, telling people like, nah, I know what you read, but I've seen it, so I'm going to tell you what it means. Uh-huh. This is His Majesty in glory, resurrecting Christ. Like we testified last night at the radio station. Nothing is created until it's created. Okay. So where's Christ's kingdom?
In us,
but and many people will say, oh, it's in us. No, but where is it in the flesh? Don't you believe that what he says
is
going to come to pass?
It's His Majesty, of course.
Well, yeah, but until they listen to the one sent.
Yes.
But how can one be preach unless he be sent? Mm-hmm. So they not listening to the angels, and you entertaining me.
Exactly.
Be careful lest ye be entertained, because you never know when you're entertaining angels. See, angels don't have to be your imagination. Exactly. It's a messenger.
Exactly.
And I got a message to you. Haile Selassie first is a manifestation of God the Father.
Guess
who's got the power to be like, all right, this guy's not gonna get it. I'm gone. And you'll never know that you were speaking to a real live angel.
And you're being judged
You know, you just gave away your opportunity to receive the fullness.
Well, yeah, and people don't understand. Like, in Imperial China, like, for instance, like, when the kingdom took over,
There was representatives who came and was like scouted out the place and let people know like what's the new rules, what's the new custom, what's going on.
That's it's about to come. That's interesting.
It's about to come. Well, no. And we're
No. Like, here's like the thing. Here's the thing. Okay, you know, here's like, the thing. David. This is what John the Baptist said.
Tell it.
The kingdom is at hand.
Oh.
It's at your reach. Just like you could reach up for the Amen. To grab fruit from the tree of knowledge and good of evil.
Yeah.
Same is the tree of life. Here I am.
Yeah.
It's within your reach. All you gotta do is like Ethiopia, stretch forth your hands to God.
Oh yes.
But no. See, when it comes to doing bad, you all up for it. But when it comes to doing good, you kind of back down.
Uh-huh. Exactly.
See, when America is told to go to war, oh yeah, you know, you rally up, you know. When America's told that Super Bowl Sunday, oh, there's enough money, you know. When America needs rims that spin on their vehicle, oh, there money is in abundance. But when it comes to, wow, let's invest in the educational system. Wow, the economy, it's not doing that well. Oh, how about let's cure disease? Well, you know, we don't really have funding for that. Exactly. It's the Super Bowl Sunday. I'm down to pay like $5,000 for the worst seat.
For fantasy football, dude.
Yeah.
Okay, what about the education? Oh, we're not going to talk about lottery. Well, it says, lottery.
But we all, with open face, Mishpat Sayum Panim,
assume your position
and recognize him that is set or elect
in your face,
in your face or the face of God representative.
Messiah. Judge
ye what is the spirit of life and stop feeding the flesh. Who cares if he's black? Who cares if he's from Ethiopia? Who cares if it's not the way it happened in the movies?
Who
wrote the script?
This is an illusion and this is his production, my friend.
But
are you written in the script? Are you written in the book of life? Because I and I coming from a media background. Are you in there or are you just an extra?
And with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord and changed into the same image from glory to glory, even as the Spirit of the Lord. So wherever he be, Jesus Christos, he looked like he looked, he acted how he acted. If ones is a part of it, you recognize. He said, hey, because we hear his voice. You heard a trumpet. We heard a beautiful voice of grace and mercy. Now he said, I'm going to go. Don't trip, though. Don't trip. Don't stumble. Because you're going to see me, but you're not going to see me. But I'm going to send you a comfort. I'm going to send you a comforter, too.
I'm
going to send you a comforter. No, that's good. Sorry. I'm in disguise, you know, because you know, I can't make it that easy for everyone.
I'll send you a comfort.
So you'll see me, but you won't see me.
Comfort her. Comfort Zion.
But I go to the Father.
Yes, sir.
And in the Father, we see him.
Yes,
sir. Very clearly.
I am his.
Because how he is, he is. You know why? Because he created us to his image and his likeness.
Your dyslexic is highly the first Selassie. Yes, Aya. His kingdom. Yes, Aya.
Well, now, chapter 20 of Exodus. The first law. And God spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God. I am who I am.
Yes, sir.
God. Ha. Yahweh Elohim. Yahweh Elohim.
Yes, sir.
Or either it probably says I am who I am, yes, God Elohim, yes, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage, thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Eha. How does it say?
Thou shalt not make to thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them, for I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers. Okay, so basically. And thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain.
Mm.
Name in vain. His name is I am who I am.
Yes, sir.
So who is it?
How do you say that in Hebrew again?
Yahweh.
Yahweh, but isn't it the Ahe Ahe? It's not like this in Hebrew, how he says in the Hebrew, the Echa.
Something like that. I am who I am. Go ahead.
Yod hey wow hey that. Well, it's because of that. Asher Echia, you're saying the.
Yeah, that other word.
I'm just trying to say
he is the I am.
But he is one. So who is he? See, the thing is, not that he won't have an image and likeness. The thing is that he's going to appear the way that he's going to appear, and he has appeared in these latter days as his majesty. And whatever idea you may have had, we'll get rid of it because
he is
who he is. He sits upon the throne of King David.
I am who I am. I'll take this mask off and put it back again, like he said.
Because he's going to try you. People can't accept it because you're looking at the flesh, but you don't receive the spirit.
It's a spiritual thing because he can jump in us, you know what I'm saying? And then, yeah, man, it's his messengers, yo. So we're here as a speaker. So could a telephone be like, no, that wasn't Emmanuel who called you? No, it's Emmanuel. I was just talking. Your telephone was just a tool. So I am like just a tool. We're the telephone. We're going to tell it on. We're going to have it on and have it say. You know? He says, if I can remember it. Yeah, Echa. I am Yod-Heh-Wah-Heh, like you said, Yahweh.
Well, we actually in the new Shabbat study. See what we went into was the Shabbat study number 17. Now we in 18, and it's called Mishpatim, and in the Amharic it's called Sirat. Sherat. How do you say the coronation? Sherat Negeshtat, Order of the Kingdom. The you know how Wendam Yadam put out that book on the order of the coronation.
Mm-hmm.
Well, here's the thing. In it's called Sherat and coronation. I can't remember like the Amharic for it. But so the judgment is the coronation. It's the setting in order. So the judgment is you accepting where he sets his kingdom. You accepting him to be who he be.
Mm-hmm.
Without no interference with what you want it to be.
I am, I was, and I will be. Ehe, Asher, Ehe. From beginning, I will be to the end. Basically, Ehe, Asher, Ehe.
So, just to accept where I am. Now, actually, in chapter 21, and this is the judgment, it says... Because there's this...
And the backwards, it says, my eye. Yeah, mom. Like, ma, I.
I and I.
My eye, I and I. Backwards, dyslexic, my eye. I am.
I wonder where,
Because all languages... was created by him, Elohim. And this is a beautiful production. And for us, a big play, a big,
actually, I'm gonna look up the...
Wake up. And other people are just illusions.
Wow, check it out.
They're just extra, and they're extra. EX, and we're part of the X cross, the XY, Y, because we love him. Yes, us. Sorry, I'm just, giving thanks and praises. Because, yes, I.